Hello children, how are you? I hope you all are happy and healthy. I also hope that you all are learning a lot of new things every day. You all must be waiting for our video. And I hope after watching this video, there will be a big smile on your face. Children, today we are going to talk about the fifth chapter of the maths book for class 4th. And the name of the chapter is The Way the World Looks. So what is the name of the chapter? The Way the World Looks. So children, in this chapter, we will study about how the things that are around us look. If we look at different things from upside and if we look at different things from below, then what will they look like? Similarly, if we look at some objects from far away or if we look at some objects from near, then how will they appear to us? We will talk about all these things in this chapter. So children, let's start the lesson. In chapter 5 of your book, there is a mouse. The name of the mouse is Gappu. Gappu is a small little mouse, but a very brave one. But he is also very naughty, just like all of you. One day, Gappu saw that children were playing with a big balloon. The balloon was filled with gas. The balloon was moving upwards, and thus it got stuck at the ceiling. Gappu felt very happy to see it. He enjoyed watching the balloon. Suddenly, he thought of a trick. Next day, when the children went to school, Gappu went close to the balloon. He saw its thread hanging below it, and he climbed it to the top of the balloon. Now, sitting on the balloon, he could see the blades of fan from very near. And from there, he saw that a lot of dust is there on the blades of the fan. Looking from below, the fan looks very neat and clean. But if we go close to it, then the scene is very different. Now, Gappu looks at the other things below him. He notices that looking from above, all the things placed on the ground can be looked at very clearly. Whereas from the ground, Gappu could never look at these things so clearly. So from above, Gappu looked below and saw a bed, a chair, a table on which a lot of books were placed, and another table on which a bottle, a jug, and some fruits, etc. were kept. Now, Gappu starts looking for his sister, Chinky. He thought that Chinky must be looking for some cheese to eat. But this foolish Chinky is unable to see that cheese is kept on the top of the jug. Children, Gappu could easily see the cheese because he was sitting on the balloon that was hanging close to the ceiling. Thus, looking from above, he could easily see all the things lying below. When we look at different objects from different angles and different distances, then their shapes, size, length, breadth, etc. appear different to us. Now, Chinky could not see the cheese because she was there on the ground. It is difficult to see all the things from below. And Gappu was sitting on the balloon above. Thus, he could easily see the cheese kept on the jug. And you know what? What happened then? Suddenly, a strong wind blew and it took away the balloon outside the window into the open. The balloon started flying high, and along with the balloon, Gappu, who was also sitting on the balloon, he also started going high into the sky with the balloon. And when he saw below, he could see his home. Looking at his home, Gappu thought, "When I used to move around in the house, it used to feel so big. But looking from here, it seems to be so small." So children, when you look at a thing that is near to you, then it looks big. But if you look at the same thing from a distance, then it will appear smaller to you. So, as Gappu went higher and higher in the sky, he could see more and more things that were around his house, like a park, a gurdwara, a railway line, a sweet shop, and Suhasini's house. He could also see the water tank that was kept on the roof of Suhasini's house. So sitting on the balloon, Gappu wonders, who is roaming on the railway line? Oh, I hope it is not the Monty cat. And then he starts laughing, because yes, it was Monty cat. But looking from so far away, it appeared to Gappu like a small white rat. Now Gappu looks at the Gurdwara and thinks that yes, it must be the Gurdwara where Amarjeet goes every day. Amarjeet is the name of a boy who lives close to Gappu's house. Children, Gappu could also see a sweet shop. He never knew about this shop. A look at the sweet shop waters his mouth and he starts thinking about the yummy, yummy sweets. Oh, wow! And children, the balloon keeps on going higher and higher in the sky. And the little mouse Gappu kept on thinking that this world is so big. I used to think it is so small. Now Gappu could see a lot of houses, streets, roads, and cars. So Gappu wonders how small these cars and buses look from above, just like toys. And what do people look like? They look like small ants. Suddenly, he heard a loud honking of horn. He saw that a train was moving on a railway line and making a sound of chuk 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 chuk. He thinks that from here the train looks like a long box. And children, suddenly Gappu hears a loud sound, just like bursting of crackers. Burst! Oh, the balloon on which Gappu was sitting, it has bursted. And Gappu starts falling down. By and by, Gappu was getting closer to the ground. And the things that appeared so small from above started appearing bigger and bigger in size. And thup, Gappu fell on the railway line. And in front of her was that giant, horrible Monty cat. Now to escape from the cat, Gappu ran away from the railway line, along with the other rats. When Gappu was looking at the railway line from above the balloon, it appeared to him like this, as shown in this picture. But when he fell on the same railway line, it appeared to him very different, just like this picture. Gappu runs away from the railway line as he saw the cat there and thinks how different all these things appear when they are looked at from above. Now, here is a picture of the park which is at the back of Gappu's house. Now, look at this picture and answer a few questions. So, first of all, please answer this question by looking at the picture. The question is, mark the gate nearest to the sweet shop. You need to tell that which gate is closest to the sweet shop. A, B, C or D? So the right answer is A. So let's look at another question now. Which gate is nearest to the Gappu's house? Look at the picture and then find out which gate is nearest to the Gappu's house. So the right answer to this question is C. Now let me ask you another question, which is, if you enter from gate B, the green bench will be to your left, right or front? And the right answer is on your left. Now let me ask you another question and you can continue looking at the picture. When Suhasini entered the park, the flower bed was to her right. Which gate did she enter from? Do you know which one is your right hand and which one is the left one? So when Suhasini entered the park, the flower bed was to her right. So now you need to tell which gate did she enter from? Gate A, gate B, gate C or gate D? So now you can look at the picture and looking at the picture, you will find out that the right answer to this question is the gate D. Now, one last question that you have to answer looking at the same picture. And the question is, which of these is nearest to you if you enter from gate C? Now, you can imagine yourself entering the park from gate C. So, which of these will be nearest to you? Will it be the basketball court, the flower bed, the green bench or the seesaw? So quickly enter the park from the gate C and give me the answer. So the correct answer to this question is the seesaw. I hope you have understood how to answer the questions by looking at the pictures. So now let's look at another picture. Ismail's home. So children, Ismail is talking to his friend Srijata on telephone. He has explained to her the way to his house from Srijata's house. The picture of the same is given here. So Ismail told Srijata that she should go to the milk shop from her house. And then right after that, turn right from the second square and then cross the bridge. Go straight from there and then turn right from there. After moving further for about 100 meters, you will see a big park. And after crossing the park, you will see a small street. The first house in that street is my house. So children, now tell me, did Ismail give some incorrect directions to Srijata? Has he explained the way correctly or not? Oh, Ismail has given wrong directions to Srijata. How? He said that Srijata should reach the milk shop and then turn right. He should have said that from the milk shop, Srijata should turn left and then go straight. Then she should turn right from the second square and cross the bridge. After crossing the bridge, go to left, not right. He said turn right after crossing the bridge. But his home is at the left side of that turn. So children, if Srijata would follow the directions given by Ismail, then where would have she reached? So think and tell. If she had went along the way as explained by Ismail, then what would have happened? If she had followed all the instructions given by Ismail, she would have gone in the opposite direction of Ismail's house. So children, what will we do now? Now we will think of the way to Srijata's house from Ismail's house. That is the other way round. So please be ready and let's make the way from Ismail's house to Srijata's house. So starting from Ismail's house and going straight and crossing the park, turning right from the first square, and then after crossing the bridge and then turning left from the square. Then moving straight from there, we need to reach the milk shop. And then turning right from that square, we will reach Srijata's house. Now children, we will talk about one more thing. We will talk about Ghibli. You have heard about Ghibli, the ant, in class 3. And you have learned about it in that class. So children, Ghibli is the name of an ant. Once Ghibli saw a big box kept in front of her on her way. She could see it the way it looks in the picture. When Ghibli went close to it, she turned to its right and moved further. Now she could see an entirely different view of the same box. She could not understand what this box was. She climbed a cup kept nearby and looked at the box from there. Sitting on the cup, she could see another different view of the same box. So children, could you remember anything? When you play Ludo, you use a dice for the game. How many numbers are marked on different faces of this dice? Yes, 6 numbers in total, from 1 to 6. And I must also tell you a very important thing, that the sum of the numbers written on the opposite sides of a dice is always equal to 7. So actually, Ghibli the ant had seen a dice. So now, look at the picture and answer my questions. Yes, do remember that the sum of the numbers marked on opposite sides of a dice is always equal to 7. So the first question is, which number was on the opposite side of 5? Was it 4 or 1 or 2 or 3? So quickly answer my question. And the correct answer is 2. Yes. How could you find out the answer? This is because the number on the opposite faces of a dice always add up to 7. Thus, if we have 5 at one side, then on the other side we will have 2, because 5 plus 2 is 7. Now let me ask another question. In the picture, which number will be at the bottom? Now look at the picture. Which number is written at the top? 1. So on its opposite side, which number will be there? Will it be 1, 3, 2 or 6? So what will be the answer? The right answer to this question will be 6. Because the numbers on the opposite faces of a dice always add up to 7. Okay. Which number will Ghibli see if she again turns left from 5? Look at the picture and see. If Ghibli turns left from 5, then which number will she see? Will it be 4, 6, 3 or 2? And the right answer to it is 3. And what will this box look like if you open it up? Mark the correct picture. So you need to imagine the correct picture and choose from here. Now imagine you are opening up the dice. Here again, keep in mind that the sum of numbers on the opposite faces of the dice should add up to 7. So the right answer here is A. So children, come. Now let's do some questions related to the chapter here. Question number 1. In the given picture, you see three objects: a bowl, a pencil, and a rubber. How will these things appear to you if you will look at all these things from above? You will have to make the picture. What does a bowl look like when seen from above? How does a pencil look when seen from above? And how does a rubber or the eraser looks when seen from above? Make a picture of them all. Let's do another question now. Question number 2. Make a picture of a shoe when seen from above, from a side, and from the front. That is, you need to draw the top view, the side view, and the front view of a shoe. Thus, you will have to make 3 different pictures of the same shoe. So children, that was all for this chapter. And I hope you all must have enjoyed this chapter a lot and have also understood it well. Thank you children. Have a nice day.